welcome back to another one of my build videos. Thanks for staying tuned in again. I don't know if you guys already saw my Stam DK build, but if you haven't, go ahead and check it out if you're into that. This is gonna be the Stam Sword that I've been using. I do have a couple of videos also displaying him, not like a lot, but I did attach some videos to the end of this build. You can see our stats, unbuffed, they're not so bad. At the very beginning though, you can see the pictures. I took the pictures of the stats fully buffed. That's with our Cyrodiil passives up and our potion. We have really, really good recovery. We have really good weapon damage also. Well, our stam's a little low. There's a few things you could do to make up for the stam. We're running 35k. Fully buffed, we're at a 4,500 weapon damage, so you could replace the warrior for the tower. So you'll lose out about 230-something weapon damage. You'll gain about 2,000 plus stam, so you'd be sitting at 37k stamina, which is a lot better. So it's 4,199. This is without our Cyrodiil passive. So the weapon damage, I mean, weapon-wise, you have tons of damage. It's pushing out really good damage. Tooltip wise, it's pretty good also, but you could maximize it more and get the best out of it. You could also replace a few skills for something else. Oh, we have a 17k Dawnbreaker. It would go up if you have more stam also, so that's a plus. You know, I would recommend going to tower. I actually went after this video and replaced my Mundustone. See that 18k Dawnbreaker, and again this is with 35k stam, so you could get it higher. All you have to do is get that Mundus going. You can also replace this for sorry guys, but yeah, you could have easily replaced it for that bound armor or bound armament, which gives you more stam, and that's how our tooltip was a lot higher. You could also use crit roll. I don't use this. It's a really good heal. I hardly use it. I probably should use it more, but I prefer poison inject. We are running a master bow, so our poison inject gives us even more weapon damage. Even the more reason to replace Munda Stones. But it's still hitting high. I mean, if you wish to go, you can even go with the serpent to get more recovery. If you feel like that's a thing, but because of Dark Deal, I don't feel like it's so necessary. This OT right here, it's also based on your group. So I run Ballista if I'm running solo or like one or two guys, you know, like really small scale. I just started running it, and I really like it because it applies so much pressure. But if you're running with a decent group, or you're even, you know, you're in the middle of a Zerg battle, I do recommend running the Negate. Because it's so strong. This is it. This is our setup. We're running Asylum Greatsword, and we are running the Master Bow. Now, if you don't have these, you could easily replace them. I guess you'd have to use some kind of random weapons, unless you somehow incorporate a second set into this build, so that way you don't lose out on too much. We're running poisons here on this build also. I'm using a lot of poisons on my builds lately because it's so cancer out there. So we're running 5 Shackle Breaker, 2 Heavy, 5 Medium, and 2 Bloodspawn. Now if you saw the stats, our resistances aren't really, really high, but Bloodspawn helps us get there. So every time Bloodspawn procs, you know, you become a little bit tankier. You could replace Bloodspawn also if you feel like you want to run 5 Heavy Shackle Breaker and instead of the 5 Medium. But I'd rather run the 5 Medium. But if you do, you could go 5 Heavy Shackle Breaker. You have higher resistances. And you could put something like Veladrith or Selene's, something that increases DPS rather than resistance and recovery. So that's it. That's our basic setup. We're running 2 Bloodspawn, 5 Shacklebreaker, and 3 Agility. With Asylum Greatsword and the Master Bow. Now, if you can't get these things, you could replace the Asylum's actually pretty easy to get. You could possibly get an Asylum Bow also. Asylum is like a really easy trial to run on normal. You can get on normal, still get the same drops. Just lose out on like a little bit of bonus. But the bow, the back bar, I always run powered on my back bar. I try to as much as I can because of the extra heal. It's so nice to have that extra heal. That's our main setup. Skill-wise, you saw the skills are pretty basic also for our bow. Another thing too, you could also run tri-stat because we're running five medium. We're also lacking a little bit of health. And so you could run tri-stat glyphs on your big pieces. And this is our setup with heavy armor. So you can see the resistance difference. So you do gain more resistance. You drop some recovery and some damage, but you go from 41.99 to 38.31. You guys can see it for yourselves. The damage difference. But like I said, we don't have really any issues as far as medium armor. This is our CP layout. Again, I'm moving really fast, so you guys can always go back and check things out. I just don't want to bore y'all too much with these things. The blue trees also, I've been testing the blue tree out. This is the most efficient setup that I've been able to come up with. I'm sure we can come up with something that hits even harder than this, but as of now, this is what I've been able to pin together. So I hope you guys enjoy the video. I hope you better this build out, you know? I mean, if it works, it works, right? But if you guys come up with a better second set that we can pin it together, we can test it out. Again, sorry I've been somewhat absent. I've been jumping back and forth from the
Wait.
PC to the
Oh, here
console.
it comes.
But
here comes two of them.
so enjoy the video, guys. Enjoy the clips. Have a good one, and thanks for sticking around. Thank you.